The hadith is about Abu Huraira رضي الله عنه, but it is narrated by a sub-narrator, one of التابعين, whose name is Abu Ayyub Sulaiman مولى عثمان ابن عفان. And the word مولى means a servant who's freed by his master. So there is still wala, ties, connections. So Abu Ayyub, who was a servant of Uthman ibn Affan, may Allah be pleased with all of them. قال جاءنا أبو هريرة عشية الخميس ليلة الجمعة فقال أحرج على كل قاطع رحم لما قام من عندنا فلم يقم أحد حتى قال ثلاثا فأتى فتى عمة له قد صرمها قد صرمها منذ سنتين فدخل عليها فقالت له يا ابن أخي ما جاء بك؟ قال سمعت أبا هريرة يقول كذا وكذا قالت ارجع إليه فسله لما قال ذاك؟ قال سمعت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول إن أعمال بني آدم تعرض على الله تبارك وتعالى عشية كل خميس ليلة الجمعة فلا يقبل عمل قاطع رحم أي فلا يقبل الله عز وجل عمل قاطع رحم. Right. So Abu Ayyub, the man whom we said that he was a servant for Uthman ibn Affan, may Allah be pleased with all of them, said Abu Huraira رضي الله عنه visited us on Thursday evening, the night before Isha. Then he said, everyone here who is severing ties of his kinship is constricted when he leaves us, which means if he doesn't leave our gathering, he's blameworthy. And he's committing a sin. I don't permit anyone who's severing his ties of kinship to sit with us in this gathering. But no one left until Abu Huraira repeated the statement three times. He will be blameworthy. He will be committing a sin. Whom? A person who's severing the ties of his kinship and is still sitting with us. So a young man went to one of his aunts, paternal aunts. He left after he heard that three times. And then he went to his paternal aunt, whom he had severed her ties for 2 years. Subhanallah. So when he visited her, she was kind of shocked. And she said, my nephew, what brought you now? So he said, well, I heard Abu Huraira saying such and such. She said, we'll go back to him and ask him, why did he say that? So Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, answered him, saying, well, the actions of the children of Adam are presented before Allah the Almighty on Thursday evening, which is the night before Jumu'ah, Friday. So the Almighty Allah doesn't accept the actions of someone who has severed ties of kinship. This hadith, obviously, we studied similar hadith before, such as when the Prophet ﷺ was asked, why do you fast regularly on Thursday and on Friday, on Monday? He said, because our deeds will be presented before Allah, and I like my deeds to be presented while fasting. Then also he said, with regards to Mondays and Thursdays, and with regards to the middle of Sha'ban, that the Almighty Allah will look into the good deeds of his servants on these days. But whenever there are two people, two Muslims, who are not talking to each other, they are boycotting each other, the Almighty Allah will say to his angels, أرجئ هذين حتى يصطلحا. Postpone the cases of these two guys until they reconcile. So Abu Huraira رضي الله عنه was kind of practical. When he was sitting and he was teaching, he wanted to bring to the attention of the audience the importance of صلة الرحم and بر الأقرباء, being dutiful and kind to one's parents and relatives. So he said, whoever is severing the ties of his kinship, whoever is not talking to any of his relatives, is not permitted to sit with us. This is really embarrassing. And anyone would avoid standing up, because if you stand up, that's a scandal. You'll be exposed. But Abu Huraira insisted, and he repeated that another time. And no one got up. And Abu Huraira repeated that another time, third time. Some people got up because they figured it's going to be really problematic. Abu Huraira will prey on us. So when Abu Huraira said, "Uharriju," I do not permit, and whoever would sit down while cutting the ties with any of his kinship is committing a sin, this young man got up and he left. He went to one of his aunts, paternal aunt. In Arabic, when we say amma, refers to the paternal aunt. When we say khala, it refers to the maternal aunt. And the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said about al-khala, she is a mother. The maternal aunt is like the mother, exactly. So this young man, this youth, left, and he visited his paternal aunt, whom he did not see for the past couple years, in Medina or wherever they lived, and he was severing his ties with her. So he visited her. She said, "My nephew, tell me what has brought you here." And now, after a couple years, you haven't been talking to me. So, well, I got to tell you the truth. I was sitting and Abu Huraira showed up and he said, "You know, if you're severing the ties with any of your relatives, then it's not permitted for you to sit here. So I got up and I came to visit you." She said, "Would you please go back to Abu Huraira and ask him why did he make a big deal out of it?" And he said that, "I do not permit one who's severing the ties of his kinship to sit with us." So he went. And then when he asked him, he said, "Because I heard the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying that our deeds will be presented before Allah on Thursday evening. The following day will be Jumu'ah. So now there is no conflict of interest. The first hadith talking about Mondays and Thursdays. And this hadith is talking about Thursday all the way until the evening. Bottom line is, you don't want your name to be deprived or scratched or put X on it. I don't want to see the deeds of this guy." Why? He's not talking to his uncle. He's boycotting his brothers. He didn't visit his sister, even though she's living next door or a walking distance. He didn't enter her house because he's boycotting her for the past 5 years. If anyone is like that, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Allah will not look into his good deeds. So when you visit this person, you're doing yourself a favor. When you pull the ties of your kinship, you're doing your own self a favor. In addition to, the Almighty Allah said, اَدْفَعْ بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنُ السَّيِّئَةَ فَإِذَا الَّذِي بَيْنَكَ وَبَيْنَهُ عَدَاوَةٌ كَأَنَّهُ وَلِيٌّ حَمِيمٌ. By making a special effort to go to visit فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ, even if this uncle or cousin of yours hates you, this will undermine the conflict between you. Why? Because you're making a special effort. You're not saying, "I don't care about him, hell with him." No, you're going, you're making an effort. You're taking the risk of being expelled, of not being well received. But you're doing this for the sake of the Almighty Allah. We'll take one more hadith, which is the last hadith in the chapter, before we take a short break, inshallah, my dear viewers. Before I take the hadith, I would like to emphasize and reiterate the last statement in the previous hadith, hadith number 61. فَإِنَّ أَعْمَالَ بَنِي آدَمَ تُعْرَضُ عَلَى اللَّهِ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى عَشِيَّةَ كُلِّ خَمِيسٍ لَيْلَةَ الْجُمُعَةِ فَلَا يَقْبَلُ عَمَلَ قَاطِعِ رَحِمٍ, which means, When all of these are being presented before Allah, like on Thursday night, the following morning will be Friday, Thursday evening, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, indeed, Allah does not accept the good deeds of a person who severs the ties with his kinship. Is it worth it? It's really scary. You're taking a big risk. You're taking a big chance, which may ruin all your good deeds. After all, it's your own maslaha. It is your own benefit. So you want to overcome your desire and your ego and reach out to your relatives, your uncles, your aunts, and whoever, and pick up the phone, try to break the ice. Happy Dhul Hijjah, happy Eid. We are approaching blessed days. So I'm praying for you guys, and you include me in your dua, etc. It is your call. But if you say, you go for Hajj, you go for Umrah, Ramadan after Ramadan, and you're not talking to any of your relatives, it's your call. You're depriving yourself from the reward.